Thanks to ancient folklores, cultures, and of course Hollywood, the stories we hear about dragons often leave us fascinated and in awe. We often wish that these majestic creatures were still alive, that is, if they ever lived. The good news is, dragons do exist. But just before you get all too excited and eager to know where you can find them, the dragons that currently exist differ greatly from HBO's Game of Thrones fire-spitting or ice-spewing dragons. Unlike the Western conception of dragons, as huge flying beasts possessive of great wisdom, magic, and the ability to spit fire, the dragons that exist today are ground-dwelling giant monitor lizards, reputed not for fire-spitting, but bacteria-dripping and a venomous bite. Komodo dragon, as it is often called, is the largest living lizard, easily identifiable by its massive flat head, yellow forked tongue, strong muscular necks, bowed legs, sharp claws, and powerful long tails. They come in various colors of green, brown, dark yellow, and gray in young dragons of 5 years and below. From 6 years and above, however, they are generally gray, earthen red, and some being almost black. Their physical structure and general habit accounts for why locals refer to these dragons as ora, which literally means land crocodile. Like crocs, they have long, powerful tails, excellent swimmers, several rows of teeth, massive flat heads, and sharp claws. The Komodo dragon is definitely not one of those animals you should have on your list of favorite pets, especially given their deadly bite and impressive weight and size. But just how much do they weigh? The Komodo dragon can weigh as much as 330 pounds, or 150 kilograms, and has an equally impressive size to back it up. From the tip of its long tail to the tip of his mouth, the Komodo dragon has a total length which measures up to an amazing 10 feet, 3 meters. Combined with this impressive beastly size and weight is the armament of long sharp claws, 60 rows of short serrated curved teeth, hard scaly skin, bacteria-saturated saliva, and a venom to top it up. Whatever you do not want to get in the way of this animal. It is the king of all lizards and knows it. That's why it walks with such majestic swagger wherever it goes within its kingdom. But where are these Komodo kingdoms often found? Komodo dragons are a rare surviving species and, as a result, they are found in only 5 islands throughout the world. 4 of those islands are within the Komodo National Park, while the 5th is the island of Flores. These dragons are so popular to the extent that they have a whole island and a national park in their name. Located in southeastern Indonesia, the Komodo dragon rules over the Lesser Sunda Islands of Komodo, Rinca, Gili Dasami, Gili Motang, and the island of Flores. The first 4 islands make up the Komodo National Park, while the 5th island, the island of Flores, Komodo dragons roam freely. Though these dragons are currently limited in habitat to these 5 islands, fossils show that they were once widespread across several continents and countries. Evidence obtained from these fossils has also convinced researchers to believe that Komodo dragons evolved in Australia and from there spread westward to India and Indonesia. These fossils discovered in eastern Australia also showed that Komodo dragons have been around on Earth for at least 4 million years. It is therefore no surprise that these predatory lizards have had time to evolve to its current gigantic size. Another fascinating fact about these modern-day dragons is that not only have they been around on Earth for so long, they also get to live for so long too. On the average, a Komodo dragon lives to be 30 years old in the wild. Take note, on the average. This begs the question, just what do they eat during their lengthy lifespan? Komodo dragons are carnivorous and cannibalistic animals that are notorious for being a fast, gluttonous eater. It has been observed that a Komodo dragon can eat up to 5.5 pounds, 2.5 kilograms of meat in just 60 seconds. Just as they have a voracious appetite, so also are they gluttonous, as they sometimes eat up to 80% of their total body weight. Komodo dragons will eat just about whatever comes their way. The young ones often feed on small prey such as insects, lizards, birds, and snakes. They move up the ladder upon their fifth birthday and proceed to eating larger prey such as rodents, monkeys, goats, cattle, pigs, and especially timor deer. By nature of their evolution and hunting strategy, the meal of a typical Komodo dragon consists largely of carrion. Komodo dragons are solitary hunters, often wading along the path that prey often takes. They can remain on a spot for hours, waiting until the right game walks the wrong way. All it takes is just a single bite, and even if the prey escapes, it will eventually end up in the dragon's belly. The Komodo dragon has a deadly bite, which kills its prey in 5 days at most. Their saliva contains at least 58 virulent bacteria, which causes the bitten spot to develop deadly infection. This bacteria-loaded saliva is understandable since the meal of a Komodo dragon consists mostly of dead matter. Let's not even talk about how repulsive its breath would be. Coupled with these bacteria-laden saliva is yet venom, which causes massive internal bleeding. The dragon itself is immune to these bacteria and venom as it possesses a robust innate immune system according to the results of the sequencing, assembly, and analysis of Komodo dragon genome, a research performed by BMC Genomics. The Komodo dragon can track its wounded prey for up to 1.6 kilometers or 1 mile. It has a keen sense of sight and smell using its yellow forked tongue, which helps distinguish the direction from which the smell is coming. Being the largest predator in its habitat, the Komodo dragon has no natural predator, except, of course, humans. Adult Komodo dragons often prey on the young ones. To evade the cannibalistic tendencies of older dragons, the young ones often live in trees, which the adult can't climb. As noted earlier, Komodo dragons used to be prevalent in Australia and even India. They are now restricted to the 5 lesser Sunda Islands of Indonesia. Another thing is that there are 4 times more males in Komodo National Park than females. Given these factors and excessive poaching by locals, the Komodo dragon is listed as endangered by the International Union for the Conservation of Nature. There have been several verified reports of Komodo dragons causing the death of locals and tourists. There is a June 4, 2007 report by the guardian of an 8-year-old boy who lost his life to a Komodo dragon. So also in another report by The Guardian and CNN dated March 24, 2009, a fisherman was also mauled to death by these beasts. These are valid proofs that even though it is rare, a Komodo dragon could attack and maul a human to death. They often shake and fling their prey from side to side. Even though they are not mystical as the mythical fire-breathing Western dragons, the Komodo dragons are nonetheless an impressive species of monitor lizards. They are an ancient relic that has survived several mass extinctions. It would therefore be a shame to see them become extinct due to direct or indirect human activities. It is also advised that tourists should not venture too close to these reptiles since they are quite agile and their bite can be fatal.